Welcome watching fourth part of the video tutorial how to fix or how to repair Nilfisk pressure washer E 140.3. In previous parts you were shown in first part how to set apart or disassemble power washer, in second how to change the oil, replace the oil seals, water seals. And in third part, you could watch how to replace inlet and outlet valves. And in the fourth part, you will have a chance to watch how to reassemble back power washer or how to set it back again. Maybe you are asking yourself, we weren't shown how to replace, for example, start-stop valve or non-return valve. That's the beauty of this particular power washer compared to other brands or other models, that you don't have to set apart the whole power washer to be able to replace the start-stop valve or non-return valve. These two things you will be shown how to replace them in the following videos, and you will see that you have to disconnect only a few parts. You don't have to set apart the whole machine. What are we going to need today is Torx 20 screwdriver, pliers, flat screwdriver, maybe a hammer, silicone grease, liquid moly, and a few more bits. As you can see, we've got everything ready on the table, including induction motor and other stuff. We can start by placing MPU back cover back into the body of the power washer. Like this. And tighten one Torx 20 screw. It. Now we can place back into the body of the power washer induction motor itself, like this. Put inside the non-return valve with the o-ring facing down, and then followed by spring. Just have a look inside the hole and check whether the spring is placed properly. Now we can connect the inlet hose like this. Take the U-pin, metal one, help yourself with the pliers like this, and put it in. Okay. Now we can connect the part where is the switch and capacitator, this part, and
Okay, we got it.
And now you have to tighten 8 screws, 8 20 Torx 20 screws, 4 on each side.
Take out that one screw and try to do it again. It would be easier if I got magnetic screwdriver, but I don't have one. I prefer to tighten those screws with hand, not with the cordless screwdriver. You can feel it. And you know that with the hand there is a smaller chance that you can damage threads. I think if you do it with the cordless screwdriver, it's 2 Newton meters torque. As is written in manual, Nilfisk repair manual. And the last one, 8. Okay, that's it. Now we can connect the wires. So the capacitator is connected, the brown and the blue cable are connected on the left hand side. So first is the blue, then is the brown, and the micro switch is connected on the right side. The first is black and then blue cable. Okay, so now we have it. And the last one is yellow and green. Okay, you got everything now. We can connect now micro switch to the start-stop ventil, start-stop valve. We can do it with the hand. It should click. It went nice and smoothly. Just make sure that this cable is positioned as you can see now. Now we can attach this front part of the main switch. Do it the way the first at the top and now over here with one Torx 20 screw. Now we can attach this part like this. We have it. Don't forget to place this kind of foam over here. It is protecting cable, because the next step is to connect NPU floating front cover like this. Again, tighten it with the one T20 screw. That's it. Now we can place back the cabinet styling cover. Is this? Make sure that the two hooks over here are in the correct position, please. On the top, like this. There you have it. And the last step will be to install this feed. I've got two Torx 20 screws over there, and I'll do it like this. Another one. The last step will be to connect the filter like this, or original, even better is original Nilfisk one. And now we can place the cable, plug the cable back where it was before we started repair. And as you can see, we've got everything ready. I can position the power washer in upright position now. And I have shown you everything what I wanted to show you in this part. In the next part, I will show you how to easily replace start-stop valve and then non-return valve. We won't disassemble whole power washer again. We will just take down or take off the styling cover and this MPU floating cover, and I'll show you how to do it. So that's everything. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and good luck.